Hi, welcome back to Movie Review Mom. And if this is your very first time visiting my channel, yay, you found me. I'm so glad. While you're here, click on that subscribe button and that bell notification, and you'll be told every time I upload new movie reviews or trailer reactions, which is every day, which is kind of awesome. So let's get started. Today, the movie I'm reviewing is called R-E-S-P-E-C-T, Respect. This inspiring drama is now available exclusively in movie theaters. Now, I know it'll go to streaming later, eventually. I just haven't been given any information on when and where. So if you want to see this, you got to go to theaters right now. So the movie is PG-13 and it is 2 hours and 25 minutes long, which is a really long movie, and it kind of feels a little bit long, but I'm jumping ahead of myself. Let me give you an overview in a nutshell. I'll point out things I really liked and didn't like about the movie. I'll offer tips for parents, themes worth talking about, and even some recommendations for other movies that I think you'll also really like that are somewhat similar to this one. All right, let's get started. Bring on Oscar season. Following the rise of Aretha Franklin's career from a child singing in her father's church choir to an international superstardom, Respect is the remarkable true story of the music icon's journey to find her voice. So let me tell you the things I really liked. As expected, Academy Award winner Jennifer Hudson is jaw-droppingly awesome. Aretha Franklin actually handpicked Jennifer Hudson to play her in the movie. Smart choice. The only choice, really. Aretha asked her in real life, "You're going to win an Oscar for playing me, right?" Well, the answer's probably going to be yes. I don't know. We'll see. But she's certainly going to be nominated. At least she should be. She was that good. And the soundtrack to this movie is going to be great and probably sold a lot. Filming was actually delayed briefly because Jennifer Hudson needed to have custom-made orthotics for her plantar fasciitis, which is on your foot, and I have that too, so I know how painful that can be, where you can't even walk, and obviously she needed to walk in this movie. But the movie is now here. We get to hear some great music and learn a little bit about Grammy-winning Aretha Franklin's life. Not as much as I would have liked to have learned, but still more than I knew before. What a voice, certainly worthy of her title as the Queen of Soul. The talented cast that surrounds Jennifer Hudson makes the song Happy Birthday sound amazing when they sing it together. Sky Dakota Turner is the little actress who plays the young Aretha at the beginning of the movie and is completely adorable. And she has some impressive singing chops, too. We also get to hear Academy Award winner Forrest Whitaker sing again. Did you ever watch him and see him sing in the 2020 Christmas movie called Jingle Jangle? It's very, very sweet, very cute movie, too. This is the third movie in which we see Jennifer Hudson and Forrest Whitaker play father and daughter. The others were Winged Creatures and Black Nativity. Kimberly Scott plays Forrest Whitaker's mother in this movie, even though she's actually 5 months younger than him. So I wonder what she thought about that. She probably said, "Thank you very much for the role in this great movie." Mary J. Blige plays the legendary Dinah Washington in the film, and it is a terrible shame that we don't even get to hear her sing in the movie. How do you put her in a movie and not have her sing? Come on, especially when the movie is about music. So there is a missed opportunity there. Now, Marlon Wayans surprises in his very dramatic role, since we're used to seeing him as a goofy comedian. So impressed. It was also a joy to hear Audra McDonald sing. I wish we could have heard even more from her in the film. I loved watching her sing with Sky Dakota Turner. All of the scenes, in fact, where she was in were just so touching. Titus Burgess offers a very different type of character than what we're used to seeing him play in the TV show Unbreakable, the one with Kimmy Schmidt. And the presence of Martin Luther King Jr., played by Gilbert Glenn Brown, I thought offered a really nice historical touch that provided an important detail to the setting, especially for younger audiences who might not know that there was a friendship between those two real life people. We get to see some actual film footage from Martin Luther King Jr.'s funeral and learn about his close relationship with Aretha Franklin that I thought was very touching. I love movies that allow us to watch famous musicians in that creative process as they discover their big hits. So to take us back in time to the 1960s, several shots are actually filmed in black and white and then quickly move on to color and then sometimes back again into black and white. It was a nice touch just to remind us these are true events and to kind of make us feel like we were back then. So keep watching during the rolling credits at the end of the movie because you get to see pictures and video footage of the real Aretha Franklin working her magic during her career. And that was definitely a nice touch. Now, with all of those glowing praises, there were a few things that I didn't like about the movie. First of all, you need to know it's a very depressing movie throughout most of the film and finally offers a touch of inspiration at the end. So people who are looking for 2 hours of feel good are going to be a little surprised, I think. As far as the story with a plot, the script is kind of messy and it doesn't really even feel like a story, even in chronological order, but kind of more vignettes, a little bit of information and then a musical number and then some jumps in time and then another musical number kind of a thing. It doesn't really explain the events surrounding the young Aretha getting pregnant, for example, when she was only 12 years old. Yikes, poor baby. And she was a baby. I was curious and I wanted to know more about that part of her life. And so I found out that the father of her oldest son is Edward Jordan Sr. In Aretha's will, she clearly stated his name and identified him as the father of her first 2 children, actually. And she said in the will, quote, his father, meaning her first son, should never receive or handle any money or property as he has never made any contribution to his welfare, future or past, monetarily, material, spiritual, etc. So that was a pretty bad indictment of what a scumbag he was. She underlined the word never. He got her pregnant twice. The second time when she was 14 years old. So seriously, what kind of a scumbag monster does that to a child? Sheesh. Okay, off my soapbox, but that was interesting. And it gave me more respect for her and what she went through, including the decision to protect his name, which I personally wouldn't have done. I would have let everybody know this guy's a monster. But that's just me. Anyway, some of the accents also in the movie are a little bit inconsistent and all over the place. But let me give you some tips for parents. First of all, there is the use of the N-word several times. There are some other profanity. A man slaps a woman, unwed pregnancy, marital abuse, men fight, a man pulls a gun on another man, and then adultery is talked about and some scenes of people in bed, not wearing any clothes except for, you know, a sheet covering them. So some of the themes, though, that were represented very well, I thought, in the movie are finding your voice. And the movie, I thought, illustrated that whole idea very well, that she didn't know who she was. She didn't know what music she wanted to share with the world and what was her unique message. And so I really appreciated that we all, whether we're singers or not, have to find our own voice. Other themes are love of music, of course, respect, of course, death and mourning, divorce, facing your demons, claiming your life, and change. So I always write down funny lines and interesting lines as I'm watching movies, just so that I can share them with you so you can get a flavor for the movie. So I'll share a couple of them with you right now. You can find all of them at moviereviewmom.com. So couple of the interesting lines are when Martin Luther King Jr., apparently in real life, had Aretha come visit when he was speaking, and she really supported him throughout his career to evoke change and to promote the civil rights movement. Anyway, he says, "I wish every day was Aretha Franklin Day." And I was like, wow, I didn't know that he said that. And then there's another conversation between her and her father, played by Forrest Whitaker, and her dad, Forrest Whitaker, is talking to her. And he's like, "Have you lost your mind?" And she says, maybe I found it. And that's kind of where she starts to emerge as her own person, making her own decisions. Anyway, there are a lot more, so be sure and check out my website. So overall, I thought the movie was really enjoyable. I learned a lot. You get to hear great music, but there were some flaws in the structure of the storytelling itself and the filmmaking. So my overall movie review, Mom, grade is a B. So, but wait, before you go, let me give you some recommendations for some other movies that I think that you're also going to really love. The first one being Dreamgirls. Now, it had some other great singers, but as you know, or maybe you don't know, Jennifer Hudson won an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress in her role in Dreamgirls, and very well deserved. So she's been nominated for other things since then. But anyway, another great performance by her. Definitely check that one out. And then this movie also made me think of the recent movie from last year called Judy, about Judy Garland and that biopic about her life and how that was such a great performance and touching story as well. All right, that's it for my movie review. I hope if you watch this that you do enjoy it, and I will catch you in the next movie. Thank you so much for all of your support. Bye for now.